Greetings, YouTubers! How are you all?
Good evening, and today we're going to show you, Chris here is going to show you a lesson of one of our songs. It's called Lost on the Beach.
Chris? Yes, we are Shaking Generation. This is off our debut EP. It's the second song, and I think it's also the first song,
we wrote.
The first song we ever wrote.
It was, Chris.
It's quite an easy song, there's a lot of open chords in it. So let's just get down to it. First thing to know, capo on the fourth fret. Song's in she slips. Oh my god. Already I take a couple of weepy words. Song is in C sharp minor. That's the main chord that revolves around the whole song, C sharp minor. While muting the bottom string. The intro is quite simple. You're basically revolving different notes around the C sharp minor chord. So the first chord is C sharp minor, obviously. Next chord is C sharp minor again, but put your pinky on the 7th fret of the A string. The strumming for this intro bit is quite simple. It's down, 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 down. Yeah, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down. I'll put the string pattern in the description if you can't follow it.
Yeah.
Do you know what string pattern is?
No.
I don't think so. Anyway, so C sharp minor. C sharp minor with an E. Next chord is the same C sharp minor, but move your middle finger from where it was on the 6th fret of the D string to the 6th fret on the A, and then play a full chord again. No idea what the chord's called. It's supposed to be a finger C sharp with an E flat in it. That's what I'm going to call it anyway. And then take your index finger off. That leaves it with an A flat 7, 5. I don't describe my chords pretty well, but those are the main chords for the whole song. So it's C sharp minor, C sharp minor with an E, C sharp minor with a. Where are my phone's going again? Hang on.
I'll take Chris. Is there recording? It's sound.
Yeah, man.
Just let all our viewers just chill off.
There we go. Texting in the middle of flipping lessons. What is all that about?
What are you like?
Okay, so you should have got that. C sharp minor. C sharp minor with an E. Then E flat. Quickly show you what the fingering pattern is for it. C sharp minor is obviously your A minor. Phone's going again. I'll get it in a minute. It's basically like your A minor, but obviously where the 4th fret is. And then use your pinky and butt it on the 7th fret of the A. And then middle finger, take it from the 6th on the D to the 6th on the A. And then just basically take your index finger off and then play. So the whole intro goes like this. That intro for around 4 times, then the 4th time you do it, you go, and then you play that eighth, the last chord from the first bit intro, but put your pinky on the 4th, on the 7th fret of the B, and then lift your pinky off and play that open chord again.
And then we start.
And then it gets into the main riff of the whole song, which Sava proper loves. It's this.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, he sings the vocals in the same keys sometimes. Basically, what the chords are, it's C-sharp minor again. And then it's a B5 power chord. But you have the open G, B and E strings following. So, obviously a power chord is this shape here. It's on the 7th fret, so index finger on the 7th of the high E, low E, sorry, ring finger on the 9th, and pinky on the 9th as well. And you play it as an all open chord. And then do the same again, but this time move the entire shape up to the 9th fret, while still having the open strings. So, and then again, keep the entire shape, but move all the way down to the fifth fret, while still maintaining the open strings. And then for the last chord, it's basically taking your index finger off, and then moving the other two fingers down one fret. So it's basically an A flat minor chord. String pattern is down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down. You know what? I'm not going to get into that. I'll just play it really slowly and hopefully. I'll play it slowly and hopefully you should be able to get the string pattern because I have no luck explaining it. That's the entire strum pattern for the whole verse. Now the other part of the verse, after you've played that same thing twice, what you do for the third time is play a C-sharp minor again. But this time for the second chord, well, next chord, you put your pinky on the sixth. So it's basically C-sharp major. And then next chord is basically another power chord, it's on the B again. With all the open strings, as you know. And then for the next chord, it's basically an E5, but you mute the bottom string and play the open string still with it as well. That's my favourite chord in the whole song, to be honest, it just sounds beautiful. So that bit is. Then the last bit is C-sharp minor again. And then back to B5. And then up to C-sharp minor, C-sharp major, but instead of having it like a complete bar chord, which includes the middle finger, on the 10th fret on the G, basically just take your bar off. And you play that as many times before the storytelling verse comes in. So the whole thing slowly goes like this.
Come on.
That's the entire intro section. And that occurs in all the choruses, as you may have heard in the song. Now, verse riffs is basically, again, C-sharp minor. But what you do in each of these bars is that you take these different fingers off. So for the first bit, you take your middle finger off and do hammer-ons while you're strumming. So I'll show you what I mean. It's middle finger pulling off from the 6th to the open 4th, Just remember the capo's still on the 4th fret. Then for this bit, you pull off your ring finger instead. Next bit is pulling off the middle finger again. And then this bit is quickly doing this. So you're basically just doing a quick hammer on with your pinky on to the 7th fret. Basically the chord that you saw, one of the chords you saw in the intro. And then the last chord before the verses, the vocals kick in, is that, which is a, I think it's like another C-sharp minor. Like I said, I keep losing my track with chords. I don't bother them. But it ends on that chord. It's basically, if you like, a D minor, but it's just up in this shape instead. And then that repeats around for the whole verses. So, once upon a whatever time ago, there were a couple of kids just running around in a trail of sand. And then do it again. To which, the fools as they are, managed to lose themselves at first sight. And I don't mean love at first sight, they mean they were lost and abused. So, you know what I mean? So that's the main little bits of the song. I'll just quickly go into the bridge bit, which, again, is really simple. I was originally going to be doing a solo for this, but I couldn't think of a right one to put in the key. But basically, it's just revolving around power chords again, so I guess you can call it a solo, but it's kind of more like a melodic open chord breakdown. I'll play that for you quickly. So that is basically starting on C sharp with all the open strings. Remember, all the open strings are in this this section. Down to B, and then A flat minor. Back to B, then up to F sharp with all the open strings still, but again, when you're playing the power chords up on the top, I always mute the bottom E string. Then move down to E. Then basically play a C sharp, but without the B. So you leave that open. Then back to E again. Then C sharp again. Open up, sorry. Not without the bar, obviously. Then B again. It's basically the same again. Then you end on the A. And before it goes back into where I speak, it does a quick C sharp minor. And then A flat major. So for that last bit, you basically pull your middle ring finger off from the 6th. So. And then it's back into the intro riff, which, as you already know, is... Oh, it would help if I played it right. Can't even play my own song.
God.
Oh, so lost.
One of the best songs we've ever done.
Last chord before I speak is basically the look at the finger and you'll know. I always put the pinky down in the 7th off the beat. Okay, those are the main bits of the whole song. I'll play the bits now really quickly, because we've only got like a couple of minutes. We're actually halfway through writing our first full length album. Don't know how long that's going to take, but if we nail down to it, we should get it finished. Anyway, so all the bits, fast and slowly. The intro bit is. Main riff. Don't even know what I'm saying. Can't even play it. It goes to the A.
Too early.
Talking verses. Bridge bit. Those are the main bits of the song. Hopefully you will have really paid attention to it, and hopefully you should be able to know how to play out this first ever song. We're going to play the hopefully in the next video we'll post up another blog, and then hopefully another lesson on one of our EP songs if you're interested in learning.
Probably Lego House.
Echo House, you mean?
Oh, freaking hell, yeah! Echo House.
You'll be wanting to call it Lego House soon, won't you? Okay, that's Lost on the Beach. Awesome song, in our opinion. Don't know about you. Change Generation out. Peace.